Hello, ladies and gentlemen, yet another time. As promised, between episodes, I cooked a bunch of refined iron, 27 to be exact, and you'll see in a second why I did that. So, as you can see here, we have a bunch of diamonds. This hammer is a blast to mine with, if I say so myself. As you can see, we have a ton of iron. Don't let yourself be fooled by this. We have a ton of iron, and we have a ton of other ores, so there shouldn't be a shortage in the near future. At least the base materials. There could be a shortage in steel, but yeah, we should try to cook up some as well in the near. Yeah. So let me just convert these into coal coke. I was using these to power them. There should be some amount of power in there as well. So yes, we're pretty much set. I added a second coil to this so it heats up a bit faster. The third coil wasn't really necessary, but yeah, I might use it in the future. Yeah, so let's make some rock crushers, or at least one. Let's see, we need some iron, I know that. We need some redstone, that as well. Let's grab some more. And we need a bunch of cobblestone. Where is it? There it is. And some oak wood. Let's convert this, and let's make some pistons. Piston, please. Piston. 8 pistons. That should suffice for 2 sets, so we need 4 more. What was the issue? Redstone. Alright. And 4 more. Nice. Perfect. And then we need some steel. That's it. And the diamonds, of course. So let's make 4 blocks, 3 blocks of steel. At least that's the plan. Yes, it is. Block of steel. Rock crusher. This guy right here, block of steel, 4 pistons, 4 diamonds. 1, 2, 3. Nice. Awesome. Alright, so where do we set it up? I would say down there. The rock crusher is kind of dangerous at times. Simply because, let me just check real quick if this is... Yes, it is indeed. So we might want to care for downpouring lava. If we insert this into here. Okay. There's our rock, not the rock, the blast furnace. So why don't we do it like this, and then have the rock crusher sitting right here. Alright. You know what, let's inlay it one thing into the floor. So you just want to do it like this, and then the multi-block should form. And I think it uses, yes it does, it uses RF. How do we convert this? Let's use the bat box. And let's have some cabling here. Just a second. Oh yeah, and by the way, if you saw this, I kind of had a lever running. Some rubber, please. There we go. 5. We don't have in here. Don't have. And then we need electrum wire and some MV wire connectors to convert the power. It should work, at least. It should work. Let's see. Why don't we do it like the following? We run the cabling over to here. And then we... Okay. One less cable. Fine with me. This and that. And then connect them up. Is this getting power? It is indeed. Nice. Oh my god. I'm so happy. I'm so happy that worked. If you remember the problems we had with power concerning this guy up there. Yeah, this is a blast. So let's see. The Rockcrusher crushes things. Oh, let's sleep through the night first. And then we will check this block out. Of course, we need it for obsidian mainly. So we need this crushed obsidian to make the machine case things. Crushed obsidian. This guy. We need for, yes, the assembly table recipes, this one. So crushed obsidian we get by rock crushing obsidian. But you can also, in the rock crusher, do a bunch of things involving, for example, did they remove it? No, they didn't. They wouldn't dare. Yes, this one. I really love this. Just crushing gravel into sand. Oh, sorry. Sorry about that. Oh, come on. Just crushing gravel into sand gives you a lower than 1% chance to get a diamond, but yeah, hey. It's at least a chance, I'd say. So let me grab some obsidian. Do we have some obsidian? One piece. Yeah, that's not much. That is not much indeed. But let's try it. Nonetheless, this is, no, it's not really empty. So you can, if you don't want to pump things into here, you can drop them onto the rock crusher. It gets sucked in and then it gets crushed. There we go. Crushed obsidian. Obsidian dust. Nice. And that should do it. So yes, that's all the magic. That's where all our diamonds went. So yeah, we have some left, so it's not too big of a deal. But let me just before we start to make some machine casings, let me grab a few more pieces of obsidian and I will come back once I'm ready for the next step, which will hopefully involve a tree farm of some sort. And of course, I will want to go for some sort of a bigger power gen somewhere automating this. Why is it not outputting? Hello, mister. I'm not working. Why is this not working? Break and replace type of deal. Let's try that. Oh, we don't have block. I need some blocks. Help me, please. Let's mine some. Thank you. So let's jump up here. Let's see. It was working. I'm sure of that. Is it only outputting if there's something cooking in there or something like that? No, it's definitely not outputting. That's strange. Let's see. If I throw in a piece of coal, will you suck it out? Yes. Or was it just a visual bug? Probably. Okay. Yeah, let's let this cook. And yeah. As I said, I will come back in just a few seconds once I have like 5 pieces of obsidian, I think. What's the machine? You need 2 crushed obsidian per machine frame thing. Do I need something else? Basic circuit board? I should be able to do that. Or do I need a machine casing for that? Carpenter, just a bronze, okay. Something else, machine casing. This one, and the dinosaur plates. Okay, so let me throw some Coca-Cola into a furnace. Wrong chest. I need some iron. So 1, 2, 3. Yeah, 3 should be enough. 27. That takes a while, so might as well start now. This is transferring heat. It does. Why is it? It needs the lever to be on. Normally, yeah, whatever. And some coal coke into one of the furnaces. Thank you. Okay, it's not stopping the non-pour of energy, is it? It is not. This goes down. Yes, it does. And two furnaces running, it goes up. Okay, nice. So let me grab one more piece. We have one and two. Yeah, that should do it for time being. Okay, yeah. Let's make the cut now. So yeah. Be right back. Okay, so I figured let's watch them together. Because why not? And I like the sound of the Rockcrusher finally crushing the obsidian. What can you, by the way, do with this crushed thing? Okay, you can do the rods. Have trothium dust, whatever that does. Oh, you need it for... Okay. Okay, why not? So you need obsidian powder. Yes, this was the thing we were looking at. Crystal memory. Obsidian plates and horn glass. Yeah, that's definitely useful. And it's filling up. Hello? Okay, so just some graphic bugs. Okay, so as I said, the only thing bottlenecking is the refined iron burger production. And for that matter, I will pause the video here and wait for iron to cook up into steel again. Yeah, maybe there's something else I can do. Yeah, maybe prepare the other ingredients. So what I want to go for first is a tree form, just because A, it provides us wood, which is all never a bad thing, especially since the logs only convert 1 to 2 into planks. And B, a wood farm provides us with power gen in the form of coal, and this is very useful as well. So I want to go for a planter and for a harvester, just to standard ones. So I need a machine frame, just a flower pot and some other things, which is not the big of a problem. And I need a harvester. Yes, a harvester. This one, that's just 2 infrared axes, a gold gears, redstone, reception coil. I'm used for crafting only. I should be able to make these. You know what? Let's try it. Let's try making Inmar axes. We had the problem with the pickaxe. Yeah, just check if there's an in recipe. Yes, it is, so we can make these. And once we have those two, we have a basic tree farm, and the upgrades shouldn't be a problem either, I hope. Upgrade. Let's hope. Yes, that's just the standard recipe. So we can go for let's go for a quartz upgrade, for example. That's a pretty huge tree farm. Well, like the gold upgrade is also, or the silver one is pretty big. And then we have a tree farm supplying us with wood, with apples, with coal, and with power. So this should be running 24/7 then, especially because with one harvester I can automate these. And once we have automated these, The iron we get from here, we can convert into steel. That should basically be the amount of time this needs to cook up one ingot. Is probably the amount of time this needs to generate one iron ingot. And then we have a loop that just continues to produce steel. And once we're there, Yeah, maybe, you know what? Maybe it would be a wise idea to go for this first. Yeah, no, I don't think so. Just because we need power for this. And if we don't have a tree farm, I have to just run back and forth and power this whole contraption thing. So maybe, yeah, it's probably better idea to go for the tree farm first. And once we have the tree farm, I just have to wait for another set of iron. Another set of refined iron to make a refined iron plate, and then we should be good to go. So let's start with making a carpenter, because that's what we will have to do in order to do this. Carpenter. This one. Sturdy casing, which is, oh, 4 branches times 4 is 16, plus 4 is 20, plus 6 is 26. 26 bronze, okay. That's quite a lot. So we need 1, 2, 3. There's the 4. That's like 8. 8. And then we need 16. 24. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So let's make some bronze. Oh, do we have bronze? We might have some bronze lying around. We do have 2 bronze keys. That's at least one set less. I guess, yes. Probably. Throw this in here and hope for the best. Is this? Yes, it is. So, do we have a bucket? Some plates. Yes. Yeah, I'm getting to a point where I can afford to make some extras every time I make some plates and stuff, just so I don't have to make them when I really need them. So the portable tank I will have in my inventory in case I go down there sometime soon and make some lava. So tin. Let's get this out. And just throw it into here. Let's grab the gear cast. Okay, then we need one gear. And a second one. And then we need to pour out the ingots or like the block. How much is this? 16. Okay, we can pour out one block. We don't have any bronze. Oh, we have one bronze. Okay. So we basically, I hope that's enough bronze. It's a huge amount, so this and ingot cast would have needed. One. Maybe I should. Nah, probably not. I could make a clock. Probably could make a block. I'm not sure if I can make these things I'm used to. I'm never sure. Okay, one more. And there we go. Then, alright. So, this we need to convert, and some glass. And then we need a sturdy casing. We need a bronze gears. 30 casing, I said. And we need this, a carpenter, nice. Okay, so that's one of the machines that shouldn't be connected all the time because it will draw power even if it's not in use. So let's throw this. Let's put these two machines down here. Let's make a row here. Let's mine this with awesome hammer. Whoops. Okay, so this we won't mine with our awesome hammer because of machines. All right, so the fabricator here and the carpenter here, and then we need a roof. Thank you very much. Right, so this needs water, I assume. And the power we can always run from this bat box again. Maybe I. Yeah, it should be okay. The power we can also run from up here. Just need to pick up this generator and plop it down here. It should retain its charge. Yes, it does. Where is this power going to? Oh, it's going to the compressor, I guess. Or is it? What's draining power? Something's draining power. Is it those two? Nope. This one? Yes, those two were. These two are draining power, so. Okay, that's my bad. I wasted a bunch of power, I guess. Whatever. So this should be okay. And these two. Okay, so we need to get some power down here. Let's see. An energy cell should be here somewhere. Where is it? There it is. So we can use this little visual thing. Where we can hook this up and then. This is draining power again. Yes, it Then you can close it and it's still powering this. So let's get a bucket of water. Because that's what you need. Bucket of water in the carpenter. And then we need some tin, I believe. Water. Right, so this is going well, I think. Then we need some tin and we need some redstone, I think. And then we have this little circuit thing. Circuits. This here. Basic circuit board. Some tin and some redstone, and that's all. Okay. So, redstone we have a ton, and tin we have a ton as well. So, why don't I grab a few pieces of tin and a few pieces of red. Oh, that's too much. Sorry about this. That and like this. That should suffice. That's enough redstone for sure. We need some water in there, and then we need some redstone like this, and some tin. And let's throw this in here. No power. This isn't empty, is it? No, it's not. Okay. It's getting no power. It should be getting power. Hello? Again, the power problems. One, two. It's not working. It's draining. No, it's not. Okay. There's our problem. So it might not be able to accept power from this. Maybe if I attach a copper cable to it. No, I can't. That's a shame. All right. Let me figure this out and I will come back once I have this working, basically. Okay,
No.
this is kind of embarrassing. No recipe. I believe I specified a recipe. But hey. No recipe. What? Oh, I need the water. Yes, of course. It wasn't kind of a very easy issue, so the output wasn't set to the bottom, so there was no power flowing to the bottom, and yeah, thus not getting to the carpenter. There we go. And basic circuit board. So I will be running back and forth and make a bunch of like 10 circuit boards. You know what? Let's use this tank. I'm a genius. You can tell. That was not what I wanted to do. While I wait for the steel, I will make some of these circuit boards. And once I'm done, and once the steel is cooked, I will come back and hopefully show you guys the progress I will make once I get this awesome machine casing. So yeah, see you guys in what, due to the wonders of editing, will be a few seconds. You guys in like 5 hours. Basically. So yeah, see you then.
No.
All right, so the steel is already almost finished. So I have already made one dense iron plate. I will make a second one, and let me get this out. So yeah, I always kind of keep this thing closed so I can AFK, and from time to time I will put some coal into the generator so the bat box isn't running low on energy and my steel continues to cook. All right, so let's throw in our 14 steel into this metal former. This should have enough power. Yes, it does. Nice. All right, so the dense iron plate is one ingredient. So let's throw this in here. The next thing we need is circuit boards. Then we need the iron chipsets, I think, which we have in here somewhere, this one. But I think we need some tin gears. Yes, we need some tin gears. So we'd have these. And then we need our crushed obsidian, which we should have somewhere. Right. So, if I did this all correctly, once I throw this in here, yes, I can make a machine frame. Nice. Very good, nice. Let me. Okay, we need some power in there. So this is not draining, is it? No, it's not. It is, but it's not draining from this one. Why is it not draining from this one? I don't know. Whatever. So let me real quick get the second one of the connectors. Oh, I don't have a second one, so I need to make one. So let's kick this off so we don't waste any energy. Here we go. This is cooking up. Yes, but it's losing power, of course. So hard clay plus iron, was it? Was it not? One, two, three, four, and some iron. Like this, I believe. Yes, ME wire connector. Nice. We have 8 ones. How is this going? Oh, it's slow. Yeah, I figured. I figured. Yes, by the way, power routing will be a thing I want to do next episode, along with. Is this not having power? It does. Okay, nice. Compressor, please. Thank you. And one more. So after I Volga machine, nice. After I finished these machine frames, I want to make a harvester for a tree farm. I will situate like over here. I figured I will like fill this up with dirt and build a nice little tree farm. I'm not sure what I want to do about this ore node though. So probably the tree farm will begin over here. But with the thing. Oh yeah, you can, you know what? We can also move it behind here. Over there somewhere. over here would be a good spot, I think. Just so we don't get in the way of the portal and the aura node. And yeah, it will be a good thing. Let's throw this in here. So we have at least two machine frames. Nice. So yeah, one tin gear more, and we can make a third machine casing, which will be the harvester harvesting the ore berries. So let me find two more pieces of tin ore and throw them into my smeltery. So we can get the tin gear going. Very good. What do we need for a harvester? Harvester, we need two Invaraxes, some gold gears, some reception cores, some plastic sheets, and a shears. Awesome shears. Right. So we have Invar block, we have an Invarax, no we don't. Alright, so some wood later. Some wood later. Here we go. Some sticks. And an axe. Two axes. They don't stack, of course. And then we need shears, which are easily crafted. Then some plastic sheets. I believe we had some. And if we don't, it doesn't really be that big of an issue. Like, we can't make plastic sheets. Oh, damn it. That was an issue, yes. Compressed sawdust, which we can create by using a witch's oven. Okay, so we need only need to get rocket fuel. Rocket fuel. That's in the vat. How can we create a vat? Vat. Hello? Electrical steel. Oh my god. This is ways away. So we can... Oh, I didn't plan, and now I'm getting effed over. Alright, so rocket fuel. Is there any other way to get rocket fuel? A bucket of rocket fuel. No, there's not. Huh. Plastic, there's... Only one way to get plastic, is there? Plastic sheets in the dungeon chest, okay. So that's basically the only MFR villager zoologist. Huh. I wonder if these spawning... If these things are spawning. If they are, I could go for a expedition and hope to find a village where I have, well, like find one of these loot chests with some plastic in them. But if there's, oh, we have an enderpearl, nice. There. My inventory is full, okay. Nice! And the end of the seed goes right back there. Alright, so... I should clean my inventory. So where was I? Yeah, the plastic problem. Plastic problem. What to do about this? I guess... Huh. This is a real issue. I believe we had this issue once before where we wanted to create a hammer, I think. And we wanted to make something out of plastic. And we couldn't create plastic because we had no rocket fuel. So if we can get any piece of electrical steel, which we can't because we can't make an alloy smelter. Or can we? Alloy smelter. Yeah, aluminum ingot. That's Lumium Blend, which is energized glowstone with some silver and tin. Alright. We need to get some... the magma crucible. Magma crucible. Yeah, we can do this, at least. And then we need a liquid transposer. Liquid transposer. Oh, what's it called? Fluid transposer, this one. This we can make as well, so we can create a fluid glowstone. And then we can make lumium, then we can make the machine frame and an alloy smelter. Oh yeah. Alright, so we are not that close. We are not as close as we wish to be to our tree farm, because we will need some better power gen to run all these machines, I believe. So, yeah, sorry. Huh. That's frustrating. That's really frustrating. I believe this is out of power. Yes, it is. Throw some of them in there. Let's let this run. Or at least. So, what are we going to do about this? We can always get more iron. So iron, copper, and tin aren't the real problem here. It's more time and effort. If I wanted to spare you. So. Bad times, bad times. Crafting, let's throw them in there. It's getting nothing. Yeah, let me think about this, and then I will end the episode with the outlook for the next few things we want to do in the next episode. So yeah, see you guys in a second. Let me like order my thoughts and make up a plan for the next episodes. See you then. Okay, now so my biggest concern now is power gen. So I thought about it and I have a really neat idea. I think I can pull off camera. So you guys can look forward to next episode. I will have a pleasant little surprise. I won't have to rely on this coke oven to produce me some cold coke. I mean, the cold coke we have is plenty, and I will probably reroute and reconfigure this whole contraption thing so we don't have to split our cocoa between these two generators and the three generators down there. I will upgrade the energy cell. This holds way too little power, and yeah, so this is what will happen between episodes. And next episode I want to start making the machines we have to get for aluminum, and I still want to tear into some machines, but I figured why not use another tree farm I used in the past, which is the forestry multi-farm. So this farm block with some copper and the electronite tubes should make probably enough wood to sustain itself and get some surplus of coal and stuff. So we have the farm gearbox, the hatch, the valve, and the control block, which is just the golden electron tube. So basically, I will have to get a good amount of these tin tubes and make some farm blocks. But other than that, I think it's pretty easy to craft. I will do this off camera. And next episode, I will have hopefully a nice enough power gen and a place to place this multiplom. And yeah. So the only thing the multifarm needs is some appetite thing, so the fertilizer, and this we can either use this one, the fertilizer from from forestry, but we can also use the fertilizer from industrial craft, I believe, which is, oh, they changed the recipe, did they? Yeah, it did. Okay. Me. This one. Yes, this was the one I was using in the past, the industrial fertilizer from MFR. I believe you can use it in the forestry multi-farm. And yeah, it uses some sulfur and also some string. This is the use recipe I used in the past because it's all self-sustaining. So bones, we should be able to get a few and some string and yeah. And of course, when I go mining, I will pick up the apatite, which I didn't in the past. And hopefully have enough fertilizer for this farm to run a few days or weeks. So yeah, this is the end of episode number 6, I believe. Yes, episode 6. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you stick around for episode number 7 with some power gen and some forest multi-farm, hopefully. And yeah, with this, have a nice day and see you all around.